What's going on, YouTube world? Austin, Zay back here. And in today's video, we're gonna talk about the life goals that you need to have in your 20s. And you probably have sat in school before, and at some point your teacher or your guidance counselor said you need to have a 5-year plan, a 10-year plan, or even a 15-year plan. And that probably felt like a little bit of a drag to you. And it felt like a little bit of a drag because you're living the high life, right? You're in high school, you're in middle school, maybe you're even in college, and you're focused on partying, you're focused on girls, you're focused on boys. You're focused on essentially everything but having life goals. But here's the deal, you need to be thinking ahead. And the reality of it is, if you're watching this video right now, I know for a fact you're already thinking ahead. You're thinking so far ahead that you're thinking about smashing that like button if you haven't already for that YouTube algorithm. Now I'm just playing around, but for real, what are you focused on right now? I mean, ask yourself while you're watching this, what are you focused on? And what is top priority for you in your life right now? I'm just curious. Maybe you're a teenager, you're 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, okay? And you're on TikTok, you're on Snapchat, you're on obviously YouTube. You're on Instagram and you're watching everybody literally crush life, right? You're watching Kylie Jenner become a billionaire. You're watching Jay-Z become a billionaire. And there are so many different influencers out there that you watch live their life and you're just like, man, I wish I could live that life. And all you really want to do is crush it in your 20s. And trust me when I say I've been there. I've been exactly where you're at right now if you're watching this video. You know, I've been in a place where I didn't really know what I wanted to do or what goals I should have in my life, but I knew I wanted to become successful. I knew I wanted to be somebody of influence, and I looked up to all of these crazy, cool people on social media, and I wanted to be like them. I wanted to live the life that they lived. I wanted to travel the way they traveled. I wanted to go to the parties the way that they went to the parties, but the reality of it is we need to take a step back for a moment, and we need to establish some life goals. Most people have a midlife crisis between the ages of 35 and 55, and this is simply due to the fact that they did not think ahead. Essentially, they just went right from partying and all of this crazy stuff right into the rat race. And the rat race is something that I commonly refer to as, you know, going and working a traditional 9-to-5, right? The 40-40-40 plan. But not doing it intentionally, doing it unintentionally. They essentially get themselves into this hamster wheel, and you see it, right? You see, I mean, 97% of Americans, I would say, are probably on the hamster wheel that I'm talking about, right? And the reality of it is, a lot of them did it unintentionally, meaning they just, again, a bunch of time passed, and all of a sudden, they woke up, they had kids, and they had no other real option. Now, of course, they've got to pay the bills, right? They've got to go on vacation once or twice a year, and there really is no escape out of that, and that is really unfortunate. So that is why in this video, we're talking about establishing some life goals, so definitely stay tuned. So how do you really get out in front of the problem? I mean, how do you actually end up not being one of those people? How do you not end up being like Miley Cyrus swinging on a wrecking ball, right? Okay, hopefully that is never you, but I mean, I guess the reality of it is she probably made a lot of money to do that. So maybe if you have that opportunity, I guess I would take it. But we're gonna keep it really simple in this video, and we're just gonna talk about three things essentially that you're gonna wanna keep in mind when kind of thinking about your future and thinking about the different goals that you should have in your 20s to prepare you for the rest of your life. The three main categories that we're gonna talk about are career and finance goals, personal development goals, and relationship goals. So let's go ahead and start with business, finance, and career goals. The questions that I would start asking yourself are, what are you looking for in a career? You know, what makes you happy? What are you passionate about, right? These are things that you've actually legitimately gotta consider. And I know that if you're watching this, you're probably on the fence of like, you know, it isn't easy or fun to think about the future sometimes. And sometimes you want nothing more than just to live in the moment. But, you know, the last thing you want to do is live in the moment for too long and life just kind of end up happening. So what industry are you genuinely interested in? I mean, do you want to be an entrepreneur? Do you want to be a YouTuber? Do you want to be an engineer? Do you want to be a lawyer? You know, what is it that you are truly passionate about? What is it that, you know, you could wake up every day for the rest of your life and enjoy going to work, right? And enjoy telling other people what it is that you do. Let's say you're a business owner. What does the culture of that business look like? What are the key principles that you want to establish in that business? Let's say you had a bunch of employees and in a perfect world, you had an office full of people. What would that look and feel like? What would your mission statement be? Do you want to be kind of like a quaint mom and pop shop, or do you want to be a Fortune 500 company, okay, on Inc. 100 or Inc. 500 or maybe even Inc. 5000? These are all things that you've got to consider when you're actually looking at your future. Now, you don't have to know exactly how you're going to get there right now. That is not the point of this video. But what you do have to remember is that you have to know where you want to go. One of the biggest reasons that having the end goal is so important is because a lot of times you can reverse engineer that goal. And what I mean by that is you can take the end goal, and let's just say the end goal for you is to make $100,000 a year. And you know in your heart right now, watching this video, that $100,000 a year, you would be stoked about life. You would be like fired up beyond belief, and that would make your life. Okay, take the $100,000 a year in the industry or whatever it is that you're trying to kind of accomplish that in. And then once you have that goal established, you can start to break it down and you can actually work your way backwards, essentially reverse engineering the plan so that you can actually set attainable goals every, let's just call it 90 days or maybe even 180 days or every year, and you can actually work your way towards that goal. Look, maybe this is something that is important to you and maybe it is not at all, but the key thing to remember is that if you don't think about it, you're not gonna know what is and is not important to you. Another thing to consider is savings, right? I mean, at the end of the day, if something crazy happens in the world, how are you gonna take care of your future family or even your parents or your grandparents or whoever raised you? Maybe your family right now that you're looking at, you know, you probably should consider having an emergency fund. You should probably consider putting some money aside at some point, okay? You don't have to do it the day you turn 20 or 21 years old, but these are things that you wanna consider and you wanna start to put a plan of action in place to be able to make all of these different things happen. Let's dive into the second category, being personal development a little bit. And I'm gonna explain to you why I think, in my opinion, this is so unbelievably important. So personal development can really be anything. It could be taking up a new hobby, taking up a new skill, or really whatever it is that you could possibly think of. Maybe even learning a new language, learning how to play the piano, okay? Whatever you can possibly think of where you're forced to kind of level up, you're forced to kind of think outside of the box, you're forced to learn, grow, and evolve. You know, I would say that that would all fall under the category of personal development. So what are some of these things that you would like to do in your 20s? Again, your 20s are a great kind of decade to really lay the foundation for the rest of your life. So rather than just party away your 20s, you know, you want to be learning, growing, and evolving during this time so that when you do have a family and when you are really kind of getting into your career and really kind of getting into the, I guess, meat and potatoes of your life, you have a really solid foundation laid for yourself. I know for me personally, I really want to learn Spanish, okay? I think it would be incredibly fun to learn a new language. For me, it would be very challenging, and I'm somebody that loves challenges. I get very passionate about learning things that are new to me, and so this is something that I've been considering for a long time. And the reality of it is, if I just never take action and never have a plan to make that happen, then what will end up happening is it'll never happen. So right now watching this video, I encourage you, pull out a pen and a paper and write down some different things that you would like to learn. Maybe you wanna read 100 different books. Maybe you wanna learn a new language. Maybe you wanna go to a Tony Robbins event and you wanna check out Date with Destiny and you wanna walk across flaming hot coals, okay? I don't know what this looks like and feels like for you, but what I do know is that everybody should have personal development goals. Maybe you want to hire a mentor. Maybe you want to learn a different investment strategy. Maybe you want to learn how to invest into real estate or the stock market or whatever, but you don't have the knowledge currently necessary to be able to do that. And essentially what you want to do is you want to go and obtain that knowledge. Kind of my last tip with the personal development stuff is to figure out who you are and kind of what your standards are. You know, in personal development, I think that figuring out your morals and kind of your expectations in life, your expectations not only of yourself, but of other people as well. This is a phenomenal time to really sit back and say, you know, what are my expectations of a girlfriend, right? What are my expectations of a future wife? What are my expectations of a husband or a boyfriend, okay? Or a best friend, maybe even a business partner. And what are your morals? You know, what are you willing to put up with? What are you not willing to put up with? You know, what are you kind of going to look the other way on? And what are you going to stand up for? And what are you going to actually speak about? What makes you happy in life, right? You're definitely definition of happiness will probably always change as you get older, but this is something that you really want to start to document, and you probably want to start to actually even journal so that at some point you can look back and you can say, man, it is so crazy how only a couple of years ago my definition of happiness was this, and now it has changed and evolved so much, and now it is this over here. These are things that you really want to take into account and you really want to know. The last and final thing that I want you to consider are, what are your relationship goals? Now, I'm not just talking about a monogamous relationship here, okay? I'm also talking about your friendships, right? And your family, and obviously a boyfriend, a girlfriend, a husband, a wife, but even a business partner and just people that you associate with in general. I want you to consider something. Who are the top five people in your life right now? And I know you know right off the top of your head, write them down. And what are those people doing, right? What do they do? What are their morals? What are their standards? And, you know, are those the type of people that maybe in 3 or 4 or 5 years you ultimately want to surround yourself with? Or do you think there's a possibility that there are some new people that you need to go out and attract into your life? Your social life is very important. Do you want to have a social life in the future, right? Do you want to go out every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday and play pool with your friends or go to the nightclub or whatever it is, you know, whatever your social life would consist of? What is that that you want in your future? Where is your family on your priority list? Is your family at the top of your priority list, or is your family at the bottom of your priority list? Would you rather go and hang out with your friends, or would you rather go and hang out with your boyfriend or your girlfriend, or would you rather hang out with your family? These are things that you definitely want to consider, because again, your family's not going to be around forever. And, you know, going through your 20s and into your 30s, you really want to know what you want those relationships to actually look and feel like. And really the last one to consider with your family is, what do you want your future family to look and feel like? Do you want kids? Do you want to get married? And what do you want that to look like? Maybe this was a boring video for some of you, but I hope that there is somebody that watched this video, maybe you watching right now, that got a ton of value, okay? And I hope that maybe you can start to think about the different things that are important to you in your life moving forward without just going through life, right? Without just ending up in this rat race without even being intentional about it. As human beings, we are goal-oriented. So whether that be to learn a new language, or whether that be to go out and to start a new business, or to read a new business article every single day, achieving them helps not only to broaden your knowledge, but also it helps to act as small victories in your life that obviously give you the positivity and the endorphins to do more and to live your life at a much higher level, vibrate at a much higher frequency, and ultimately attract abundance and just absolute greatness into your life. There you have it. I hope you enjoyed the video. Drop in the comment section down below what you would like to see in a future video. I would love to make it for you. I would love to get way more consistent making YouTube videos. I would love to jam pack them full of just knowledge and value so that you can live your life to the best of your ability, be in the best shape of your life financially, spiritually, physically, emotionally, and relationally. And I look forward to seeing you in the next one.